everyone. We are so glad to be with you again. My question is, why is it that it's so important to take care of our body, this physical body? And why is it that we visit our doctors? Why is it that we worry when we experience headache, chest pain? Because the reason is, this body is so precious to the Lord. First, He created us in Genesis. And then after the fall, after the sin of our first parents, we experience this genetic mutation. That's why we have to endure the process of aging and diseases, cancer. It has something to do with the first sin of our first parents, and we inherit it from them. But then Jesus is so gracious. First He created us, and then He decided to die for us. And then he was resurrected, and then He redeemed us. Not only this body, but even our sins. The death of Jesus provided payment for our past sins, our present sins, and our future sins. So He is the perfect sacrifice. I'm gonna discuss heart, especially congestive heart failure and heart diseases, because it's the number one killer in the US and worldwide, actually, for both men and women. And it's also a disease that we can actually avoid if we want to. There are things that we can do, changing our lifestyle, our habits, our eating habits, exercise. So it's not like this is cancer that suddenly we have to undergo chemo. With wisdom, with discipline, we can avoid heart diseases. So when we say congestive heart failure, it's the failure of the heart to pump blood or to meet the needs of organs and tissues in terms of oxygen, the ruah, the breath of life, as well as nutrients. See, in order for us to survive, these nutrients that we ate, me and Dr. Susan, we're snacking in here right now, this has to go to our digestive tract, and this has to be converted into nutrients, but the blood has to circulate with the help of the heart in order to distribute all the nutrients. Well, with heart failure, the heart is failing because its function actually is to receive blood from the body through the superior vena cava. It's a big vein that goes into the right atrium of the heart. Then it goes to the right ventricle, and then it goes to the pulmonary artery, then goes to the lungs. Then it picks up oxygen, comes back to the left heart through the pulmonary vein, and it has rich oxygen. And then the left side of the heart has to pump this blood rich in oxygen, distributing all the oxygen and nutrients to our tissues and organs. So that's the normal function. The right side of the heart is the one that goes to the lungs, and the left side of the heart carries the oxygenated blood from the lungs, distributing it throughout the body. But why does heart failure happen in the first place? What are the causes? Number one is coronary artery disease. The coronary artery is the main blood supply to our heart. So if you love McDonald's, In-N-Out, Jack in the Box every day, then this will clog your coronary artery. This is the one that causes heart attack. You have chest pain, you have sweating, you have high blood pressure, and all that. But not only that, even alcohol can also destroy just the muscles of the heart. We call it alcoholic myocarditis. Even viral infection can also cause heart failure. Thyroid diseases can also cause heart failure. Even the medication that we take, can you believe that? The Aleve, you know, type 2 medication like Actas can cause heart failure. Even your calcium channel blocker can cause heart failure. So it's crazy. That's why me and Dr. Susan is really advocating for the supernatural healing of the Lord and the integrative medicine. The medication that we're taking, prescribed by doctors, also has a lot of side effects affecting our heart. Like, say if the right side of the heart is affected, we call it the right side heart failure. So again, we said that it is the one that pumps blood from the body into the lungs. So what happens is there's congestion of your liver. Like, all the fluids are dumped in the lower legs. You have a big tummy. Whereas the left side of the heart dumps all your fluid in the lungs. and this fluid leaks in the pleural cavity, causing shortness of breath. And the shortness of breath could be experienced either at rest, when you are doing exertion, or when you are lying flat on bed. So you will know that the patient has heart failure because they need to prop themselves up using 2 to 3 pillows at night. So shortness of breath, edema, or a swelling of the legs, failure of the liver, and abdominal distension secondary to ascites, fatigue, chest pain. Eventually, if the heart fails, it can also affect your the kidneys, because if there's no circulation in your kidneys, then you can have kidney diseases or kidney failure eventually. So it's really important for us to take practical measures to take care of your heart. Number one is exercise. See, the American Heart Association recommends only 150 minutes per week of exercise, you know, walking, running, jogging, treadmill, high intensity training is one. Number two is your diet. Focus more on raw vegetable, fruits, avoid processed, you know, like canned goods, fast food, and all that. Always check your blood pressure. The recent recommendation of the American Heart Association is that 130 over 80 is already pre-hypertension. Used to be that this used to be less than 120 over 80, but right now 130 over 80 is already considered high blood pressure, so take note of that. It's also good to see your doctor if you have high cholesterol, if you experiencing on and off chest tightness, especially us ladies. If ladies have diabetes, they don't really present with the outright chest pain or the characteristic chest pain of myocardial infarction or heart attack. Their chest pain is only subtle. You know, they could feel as indigestion. There's no like crushing. There's an elephant sitting on my chest kind of chest pain. 30 minutes. Does not respond to nitroglycerin. Not that kind of type. Maybe they're just even complain of fatigue. Or just there's a tiny pain in my pinky, or just the jaw pain. So be mindful of that. Male patients, they're the ones that typically manifest with the textbook description of myocardial infarction. If you are having a heart failure, or if your loved ones, usually when we are in the churches training people, we ask the Lord to really restore the normal functioning of the heart, especially the valves, because sometimes it's the valve, the mitral valve, the pulmonary valve, the aortic valve, the tricuspid valve of the heart that can actually also affect heart failure. So we ask the Lord to just strengthen those valves, that they will function as designed by the Lord, to just allow blood to be pumped to the body, and for those valves to open when blood goes into the heart from the body. Number two is for the Lord to really strengthen our heart so that His breath, the Ruah, oxygen, is being delivered all throughout the body to maintain its functioning. And we ask the Lord for those who already have the symptoms to have the strength of the Lord, that they will have sustained energy. Heal the lungs as well if they have shortness of breathing, if they have chest pain and all that. And we just break the curse of a heart disease in general, especially high blood pressure, because it has a genetic component. So Father, thank you for today, Lord. For those who are listening, I know that the Lord's power can transcend social media. It's like His word being delivered into the listeners right now, that healing is possible if you believe in the Lord and just receive it right now. The Lord is healing all types of heart failure and heart diseases, including coronary artery diseases. I just want to share actually that when we were discussing Crohn's disease last week, there is this lady that actually shared that while listening, her husband was on the way to Stanford for a colonoscopy because her husband has Crohn's disease, and he said that thank God she is praising the Lord that the colonoscopy turned out negative, and she's just waiting for the biopsy. So if you're listening right now, sis, I just declare that even the biopsy of your husband is normal. There's no trace of Crohn's disease or any inflammation. In Jesus' name, amen.